Sam Manekshaw, the first Indian Army officer to be promoted to the 5-star rank of Field Marshal, was born on April 3rd in the year 1914. He spent a glorious military career that spanned over 4 decades and participated in 5 different wars. A quintessential soldier who would go on to serve as the Chief of the Army Staff, he is best remembered as the man who masterminded India's victory in the Indo-Pakistan War of 1971. That led to the liberation of Bangladesh. With a swashbuckling personality and signature twirling mustache, his name is enough to spark reverence and admiration in the minds of not only the army officials, but also of every Indian who knows about him. To mark his birth anniversary, let us look at some important highlights from Sam Bahadur's life. Born on April 3, 1914 to Parsi parents, Sam Manekshaw grew up in Punjab. Sam completed his education from Nainital's Sherwood College with distinction. A good student, he wanted to go to London to pursue medicine like his gynecologist father. But his father refused, saying that Sam was too young to stay abroad on his own. In an act of rebellion, an angry Sam appeared for the Indian Military Academy entrance examination. He got through and on October 1, 1932, became a part of the first batch of 40 cadets to be selected for the Indian Military Academy, Dehradun. After being commissioned, Sam was attached to the 2 Royal Scots. Since his name was a mouthful for most of the officers of the Scottish Regiment, they abridged it to Mr. McIntosh. Nearly a decade later, the outbreak of World War II saw Japanese forces invading Burma, which was a British colony in those days. In February 1942, Manekshaw saw action in the Battle of Sitang Bridge. During a counter-offensive, he was hit 9 times in the stomach by machine gun fire, but continued to lead his soldiers. His exemplary leadership ultimately clinched the crucial Sitang Bridge for the Allies. When the divisional commander, Sir David Tennant Cowan, heard of Manekshaw's bravery, he rushed to the battle site, whipped off his own military cross ribbon and pinned it on the wounded officer's chest, saying, "A dead person cannot be awarded a military cross." On May 24, 1953, Manekshaw was appointed the colonel of the Regiment 8 Gurkha Rifles and 61 Cavalry and continued to be the honorary colonel for the units till his death. On June 8, 1969, Manekshaw was appointed the Chief of the Army Staff. He was awarded the Padma Bhushan by the President of India in 1968 for his services in the Indian Army. As the Chief of Army Staff, he served the nation by counterfeiting the Indian Army into an efficient instrument of war. He united the Army, Navy and Air Force into a close-knit team which resulted in the defeat of the Pakistani Army in Eastern Front in 1965 and the significant achievements of the Indian Army during the 1971 Indo-Pakistani War that led to the liberation of Bangladesh. A story few people know is that, at the time of the partition, Manekshaw and Agha Mohammad Yahya Khan, the third president of Pakistan, used to work together on the staff of Field Marshal Sir Cloyd Auchinleck. Their job was to help out with the additional administrative duties that partition brought along with it. After partition, when the two military officers parted ways, Yahya offered to buy Manekshaw's Red James motorcycle. He promised to send over a princely sum of ₹1,000 from Pakistan. Manekshaw agreed and Yahya took the bike with him. However, as it turns out, Yahya never got around to sending the payment. After India's victory in the 1971 and the instrument of surrender being signed on December 16, Manekshaw was heard saying, "Yahya never paid me the ₹1,000 for my motorbike, but now he has paid with half his country." For his unfathomable services towards the nation, he was awarded the Padma Vibhushan in 1972 and was given the rank of Field Marshal in 1973. Such was the respect Manekshaw commanded in the military world that when he visited Nepal after liberating Bangladesh, King Mahindra conferred on him the title and sword of Honorary General of the Royal Nepal Army. This was the beginning of a tradition whereby the chiefs of the 2 neighboring countries are made generals in each other's armies. Manekshaw was a man impervious to political pressure. Talking of his courage in standing up to the polity, it's impossible to forget the time he looked straight into the eyes of an all-powerful Prime Minister Indira Gandhi and steadfastly refused to follow her orders of launching immediate military operations against East Pakistan. Pointing out that it would be premature and inopportune, he also told her in no uncertain terms that if she did not agree, she could appoint a different general. Sadly, it was this outspoken behavior that led to Manekshaw not being accorded the benefits and status due to a field marshal for much of his life. In fact, when he died, none of the three service chiefs attended the funeral to pay their last respects, nor did the then Prime Minister or the Defence Minister. A legend who faded gracefully into retirement, Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw was an extraordinary soldier whose first-class military leadership uplifted an Indian army that stood crestfallen after the 1962 Chinese debacle. Manekshaw succumbed to pneumonia on June 27, 2008. In 2014, a statue of Sam Manekshaw was erected in Wellington, the place where he died, in his honour. Reportedly, his last words were, "I am okay." Asianet Newsable salutes the bravery of Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw and the sacrifices he made to make our motherland proud.